These observations leading to these theories are applicable in senses beyond the scientific world, though. The third law states that for every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. The same concept can be applied to every piece of our lives, especially our roles as leaders. As I look at a room brimming with young leaders, we can unanimously agree that a leader's most primary but valuable assets are their actions, voice, and vision. Closely following these are their abilities to execute and their passion. These attributes and talents are the components that allow a leader to inspire the change they seek and prove themselves to be the role models that others must follow if they're going to drive their change in the community. Like how dropping a pebble in the ocean creates a small ripple as opposed to a boulder creating waves, the strength of a leader's voice motivates different quantities of people to strive towards a common goal. Thus, the variation in strength of a leader's actions results in the equal and opposite reaction from their team. Everything lies in the effort a leader develops and provides to ensure their vision is fulfilled. Taking a step out of the scientific realm for a moment, I want to speak about confidence, because I believe it may be one of the most understated but critical features that this generation of leaders must have. Like dogs who can sense fear in people, humans are very sensitive to those who speak to them without truly knowing what they're saying, those who believe in others more than they believe in themselves. I can openly admit, I was once one of those people, and say that 4 years ago, if someone had told me I would be on stage presenting leadership to a mass of people, I would have laughed. Despite common beliefs, leadership is not something you can be born with. It can be something you grow to develop. But to ever be a successful leader, you must be confident in yourself and in your followers. This was a lesson I learned solely through academic and extracurricular perseverance, taking risks, and learning continuously about my capabilities. After years of work, years of failure, and years of successes, I have discovered that I am a leader not because of my natural talents, but because I'm driven to change the world. This passion, daringness, and perseverance is what has made it possible for me to be the proud president of our incredible National Honor Society chapter today. One day, it'll be another one of you leading this chapter, and the best advice I can give you is to believe in yourself. If you can do this consistently, you can do everything else. As leadership specialist Rosalind Torres said in her TED Talk, What It Takes to Be a Great Leader, the leaders of our era are, quote, the women and men who are preparing themselves not for the comfortable predictability of yesterday, but also for the realities of today and all of those unknown possibilities of tomorrow, end quote. Every one of us is a leader, and every day we look into the world considering the known and unknown and seek to make it better with faith not only in our own abilities, but in those of our peers. If any of you ever find yourselves with self-doubt, remember that we are a team, each one of us a leader in our own way. We share successes and failures, and with each of these, we can only continue to strive for further greatness. I would like to share a quote from one of the most successful leaders known, co-founder of Apple and Pixar, Steve Jobs, from his Stanford commencement speech in 2006. He said, quote, your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life. Don't be trapped by dogma, which is living with the results of other people's thinking. Don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your own inner voice. And most important, have the courage to follow your own heart and intuition. They somehow already know what you truly want to become. Everything else is secondary. End quote. To all the young leaders in the room, do not compromise your vision or your originality. It is the persistence of our individuality that determines the value of our passion, our ability to prevail against the pressures of the norm in order to help those around us, and prevents us from losing sight of the leaders we truly are. Thank you.